Pass, right? For ECB, I guess. So actually, you have a class on Monday 2 to 3 and Wednesday 3 to 4. Only 2 days in a week. 2 hours in a week is your curriculum. According to your curriculum, you have only 2 hours in a week. One is on Monday 2 to 3, another Wednesday 3 to 4. Okay? So last Wednesday I was there, but nobody have joined. And Thursday everybody was, I think, ready. But I have a class same time. I have a class for mechanical two section, and I've started my class. So mechanical people have got 2 hours, including that Thursday afternoon, and you have 2 hours on Monday and Wednesday. That's all. Okay. So we had one class till now. May I know what we discussed in the last class? Anyone?
About atmosphere layers.
Okay, atmosphere. Atmosphere lo ekkada what we discussed till last? Did we completed atmosphere or started? Anyone?
Completed, sir.
Completed, okay. Then tell me about troposphere. What is troposphere? Somebody just speak about troposphere. Somebody speak about troposphere. Are once you say completed, you should be able to answer. Everyone, not the only guy who is answering me. Rest of the people also has to answer. Okay, I will just have a revision of what we discussed in the last class, and I'll proceed for the next topic. So still nobody is willing to answer that question. Right.
Troposphere is the lowest layer of the atmosphere. Water
The
Wait a minute. The boy is answering, ma. You just have to ask excuse me for them. Okay, go ahead, my dear. What's your name?
Sai Kumar.
Okay. Go ahead, Sai Kumar. Very good.
What?
Very good.
All even clouds.
Right, cloud formation takes place in this same area. Very good. And next, the other girl, speak about stratosphere. Girl, somebody was trying to answer. Okay. So I will speak. Troposphere is the bottom layer, extends from 6 to 18 kilometers, 8 to 16 kilometers, and it has that Sai Kumar, Sai Kiran or Sai Kumar was saying that it contains air. Air is a good composition of gases like nitrogen, oxygen, CO2, and we discussed about why nitrogen is more and oxygen is less. I guess, yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, ma. Then it ends at 16 kilometers, and even cloud formation takes place in this. Hydrological cycle will run so that it makes the availability of fresh water continuously all the seasons. It becomes a renewable product, right? So that is what about troposphere. And next layer is stratosphere. It starts above the troposphere and extends till 50 kilometers. And the ozone gas is present, and which protects us from UV light, because the formation of ozone needs UV light. It absorbs and protects indirectly, giving a protection. And then mesosphere. Did we discuss about it? Yes.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
It protects us from meteorites, that is asteroids, and As the asteroids coming from thermosphere and ionosphere, it gets burnt and disintegrated. This layer extends till 80 kilometers, and the end of troposphere, how could we identify that? Because of difference in the temperature difference, and at the ground level, temperature will be 18 degrees centigrade, average global temperature, and it will decrease till minus 70 to 75 degrees centigrade at the end of troposphere, called as tropopause. And then the temperature will again increase in the stratosphere. Why? Because absorption of UV light causes heat radiation, and it extends minus 75 to 0 degrees centigrade at the end of troposphere, which is known as, sorry, end of stratosphere, which is known as stratopause. And from the stratosphere, the mesosphere extends till 80 kilometers, and here the temperature again decreases because we are going far. Higher altitude, so temperature decreases from 0 degree centigrade to minus 100 degree centigrade. And from there, next is thermosphere, which extends till more than 550 kilometers. And here the temperature raises to 2000 degree centigrade and more, right? So that is atmosphere. And what is the recent changes in the troposphere? These are the benefits what we discussed we have. And what is that we are giving to the troposphere and other layers? Troposphere, what we are giving is air pollution and acid rain and global warming, increasing the solar global temperature due to trapping of solar energy, that is heat radiation in the atmospheric layers. And then stratosphere, depletion of ozone gas, causing ultraviolet rays formation, falling on the earth. And then mesosphere, radiations of the mobiles and other signals, and even the movement of the flights can change the quality of mesosphere over there. It is not yet proved, but still people expect it, right? So this is atmosphere, and next, this is how ozone formation occurs. We discussed it, and this is HOBA, the largest meteorite fallen on the earth and identified in 1920, but expected to fall 80,000 years ago. And it consists 84% of iron and 16% of nickel, one of the biggest single mole naturally available iron on the earth, and it weighs more than 60 tons. It's named as HOBA, right? Then hydrosphere, did we discuss about hydrosphere? Yes or no?
No, sir.
Right. So we will start it today. This is the fresh topic of the today. What is hydrosphere means, my dear? Hydro means?
Water.
Hydrosphere means all the water resources available in the nature, in the environment, is called as hydrosphere. All the water resources available in any form in the environment is called as hydrosphere. Right? So, what are the different water resources we have in the nature, in the environment?
Salt water, pure water.
No, that is type of water, water quality.
Ocean, seas, lakes.
Very good. Right. Oceans and seas, then lakes and ponds, then rivers and streams. Right. Why lakes and ponds? Lakes are bigger, ponds are smaller. Rivers are bigger, streams, tributaries. Riverets are smaller. Then we have anything else? Ocean, seas, river, streams, lakes and ponds. Then still we have water in any form, in any area, in the nature environment.
Groundwater.
Right, my dear, groundwater. Then that's it, groundwater. Do we have water in the solid form?
Borewells.
Borewell, both groundwater.
Glaciers.
Very good, very good. Saikiranena?
No, sir, Prithvi.
Prithvi, very good. Ah, Prithvi is also the one who frequently answers in the class. Very good. So, glaciers or polar ice caps or icebergs or ice mountains, right? This is water trapped in the ice and solid form. So that is also a water resource. Still, do we have any other form of water?
Gas forms or water molecules.
Like gas form. What is that? Water vapor or humidity or we can say fog, mist, dew, right? Anything, or cloud also, or snow, that water which forms rain, is this water in the gaseous form? Then that's it. Still, do we have any other form of water available in the nature? Oceans and seas, rivers and streams, ponds and lakes, groundwater, icebergs, polar ice,
rainwater,
water vapor. That is also water vapor, cloud. We call that atmospheric water because it is present in the atmosphere, air, right? Water present in the air atmosphere is called atmospheric water. That includes clouds, dew, fog, mist, snow, rain, everything. Still, do we have any other source of water which could be a major source? Right. Do you have water with you right now? All the students, not in the bottle,
yes,
the house, not in the bottle or in the house. Say, suppose if we don't have water in the house, what is the problem? Why do you need water in the house? Come on.
To drink.
Drinking purpose. Why do we need to drink water? Because we feel thirsty. When do we feel thirsty? When do we feel
dehydrated?
When the water is less in the body, less than what? What is the limit? Less than 70%. 70% of the body contains water. You have seen the advertisement, Pure It, Madhuri Dikshit, right? It's a fact she says over there. 70% of the body consists of water. Absolutely true, right? So where is this 70% of water present in the body? Do we have a pouch in the body so that we store water? Where do we store this water, 70% in the body?
Tissue cells.
Right. Tissues, cells, correct. Tissues and tissues are also made of cells. Cells are nothing but callus, mass of callus. Right. Mass of cells is equal to callus, and that is becomes a tissues and organs. So every cell contains 70% of water, cell sap, cell liquid, and right. So that is what. So total body is made up of 70% of water. Is it only human body or animals and other plants also? Yes, even plants and animals. So all the living beings in the environment, total living population, biotic or biospheric population, that population, 70% of it consists of water because everybody stores 70% of water. Otherwise, they will feel thirsty. So is it not that a big, huge amount of water in the environment trapped, right? We consume water. We have 70% always. So that is also a huge amount of water, which is also part of water resource. So how do we represent that water? Water trapped in the cell. What cell? Living cell, right? When the person or animal or a plant is dead, the water enters into the environment, dehydrated or evaporated again, right? So we say biological cell water, the water which is present in the living cells. So this is what the total hydrosphere means, the total amount of water present in the environment. Either it could be on the surface, on the ground, or in the air. So how could we categorize this? These water bodies can be categorized into two. One is, as already students have said, surface water and ground. Groundwater will be the borewells or open wells, whatever, aquifers, aqueducts, confined, unconfined, they are present in the ground. And surface water includes everything like oceans and seas, rivers and streams, lakes and ponds, right? All that are nothing but surface water. And then the water in the air, atmospheric water, and biological cell water, right? So what is hydrosphere? Hydrosphere includes water that is on the surface of the planet, underground, and in the air. And how much of the planet is having water? 71% of the globe is covered with water, right? 71% of the globe is covered with water. Out of that, more than 97% of the water is present in where? More than 97% of water is present in oceans and seas. So we can categorize this fresh surface water also, we can categorize in two, that is salt water and fresh water, right? Salt water means ocean and sea water. Fresh water means remaining all are fresh water bodies, right? Again, fresh water can be again classified into two, that is flowing water and stagnant water. Flowing is called as lotic, is called as lentic. Flowing ante rivers, streams, tributaries, all that rivers will flow always water. Then stagnant means lakes and ponds and reservoirs, springs, all that are stagnant waters, right? So that is what. So overall, we have more than 97% of water is there in the oceans and seas, which is called salt water. Why? Because of presence of salts like sodium chloride, magnesium sulfate at around 5 molar and 0.5 molar respectively, right? Then still we have more than 2% of water is present in the form of glaciers, polar ice caps. So how much is left now? More than 97, more than 2 becomes more than 99%, right? So we are left with only less than 1%. What is that less than 1% is available fresh water. Is it large amount or small amount? Less than 1%. Small amount.
Small amount.
Very good. Absolutely small amount compared to the plants, biotic thing. So, yeah, please somebody mute. Or is it a doubt or is it an answer? No, no, no. That's not answer. That's unmute yourself, my dear. Okay, no problem. So that's very small amount, less than 1% of water. That is why many countries in the world are still scared. I mean, there is a scarcity of water and they doesn't have enough water to be supplied for their per capita consumption. Per capita consumption and ante? How much water is required per person per day, depending on the place where he lives, like urban, semi-urban, rural, or metropolitan city, depending on that. And overall, in general, in India, 135 liters per day per head is the per capita consumption. So that amount of water is not available for the many people in the world. So why? Okay, because there is a less than 1% of available fresh water in the carpet. Okay, then. So can we bring some water, compensate the water from the surplus amount areas, like oceans and seas have got more than 97%. Can we use that water for drinking purpose? Domestic. Yes or no? Students, are you there with me? Hello?
Yes, sir.
No, no. Okay, Tagachanana, ocean water, can we use it for?
No, sir.
No.
No, why? Because salt is present, and when we intake the salt water, the dehydration, that is cell sap, will come out to adjust the salts into equilibrium. The cell membrane acts as a semi-permeable membrane, cell wall. So that could lead to a big problem in the human beings, right? So we cannot use it for domestic. Can we use it for agriculture purpose? No. Why? Even the plants have got the cells and same process will occur. That is osmosis, right? So no, two uses we can't use. Can we use this water for industrial purpose? In industrial manufacturing units, distilleries, boilers, pasteurization units, pharmaceutical industry. Yes or no? Again, no. Why? Because the metals like boilers or pasteurization units or digesters or fermenters, right, or distilleries, all that instruments are big instruments, will get spoiled, corroded because of high salt concentration, right? So we can't use that water. And even that can cause chemical reaction because it contains salts which can react with the product and manufacturing unit or process. So we can't use. So what is the use of this more than 97% of water to us? There is no use directly, isn't it? So keep it aside. To fulfill our need, shall we bring this more than 2% of glaciers? That is also good for us. Yes, we can do that. How? Start melting the ice. Where? In the mountains, polar regions. How? We need to go there with holding a candle in the house hands? Yes or no? No. Then how can we do that? We are already started doing melting that polar ice caps. How? చెప్పండి.
గ్లోబల్ వార్మింగ్.
వెరీ గుడ్. చెప్పండి అంటే నేను ఆన్సర్స్ చెప్తారా? మీకు తెలుసు, నాకు తెలుసు, మీకు తెలుసు అని. ఓకే రైట్. సో గ్లోబల్ వార్మింగ్ సిట్టింగ్ ఇయర్ వీ కెన్ డూ దాట్ అండ్ వీఆర్ స్టార్టెడ్ మెల్టింగ్ ఐస్ అండ్ వాటర్ విల్ బి సర్ప్లస్లీ అవైలబుల్ రైట్. ఇస్ ఇట్ గుడ్ ఆర్ అ బ్యాడ్ గ్లోబల్ వార్మింగ్?
బ్యాడ్.
అబ్సల్యూట్లీ బ్యాడ్. వై? బికాస్ మెల్టింగ్ ఆఫ్ పోలార్ ఐస్ క్యాప్స్ కెన్ increase the sea level and decrease the land available land area, and some places it causes unseasonal rains, floods, droughts, and climate changes, climate variation, and even the habitation of the polar region will be endangered, right? All that may die. So it is not good. So we don't want to touch that more than 2% of glaciers. So what can we do, right? So because this available fresh water is very less, and the daily water when we are using it, the amount of available water is still further decreasing, right? Day by day, the water will get decreased. Yes or no? No. Answer is no. Water will never decrease. How much amount of water is available? That is around 333 million cubic miles of water was there at the time of formation of water, at the time of Earth, formation of Earth 4.5 billion years ago, right? So same amount of water is still there, my dear. Not even a single drop of water changed, right? Decreased. Same amount of water is still available. So why that available fresh water is decreasing daily? This is a simple logical concept question. Please answer. మనకి వాటర్ తగ్గుతుంది, అది ట్రూ. నేచర్లో వాటర్ తగ్గదు, ఎంత ఉందో అంతే ఉంటుంది. ఫామ్ చేంజ్ అవుతుంది, ఫార్మ్ ఆఫ్ ద వాటర్. వాటర్ చేంజెస్ ఫ్రమ్ వన్ ఫార్మ్ టు అనదర్ ఫార్మ్, బట్ ఇట్ విల్ నెవర్ డిక్రీజ్ ఆర్ ఇట్ విల్ ఇంక్రీజ్ ఆల్సో, నైదర్. రైట్ మై డియర్, బ్యూటిఫుల్ ఆన్సర్, సింపుల్ ఆన్సర్, ఇజంట్ ఇట్? I will give you one simple example. If you take the river Musi, right? Why did this Hyderabad city has civilized here? Why many of the civilizations occur in a particular area, like Indus Valley civilization, Gangetic Plain? There we have a lot of civilizations, like Ayodhya we have civilization, Varanasi we have civilization, right? Why? Even we take the simple, not don't go far away, just be in our place Hyderabad. It is situated beside the bank of the river Musi, right? All the civilizations will start just where the water, fresh water available source is there, right? So Bhagyanagar established because of the Musi river, because that Musi river supplied fresh drinking water for the people who lived over here. Is it the same now? Can people drink the Musi river water? No, it is carrying the sewage now. Earlier it was a freshwater body, now it is carrying sewage. Why? Because our politicians and bureaucrats have merged all the sewer lines into the river and used that for carrying waste, not constructed a separate sewage line or sewage line or sewer line for collecting the waste, right? So that's how we are polluting the water of freshwater bodies with the waste sewage. So amount of polluted water is increasing, so available fresh water naturally simultaneously decreases, but no water changes, no water quantity wise never changes, right? So that is the reason. So this is hydrosphere, right? What is that? Different sources of water: surface water, ground water, water vapor and biological cell water, right? And salt water. So this is hydrosphere. Next is lithosphere. What is lithosphere means? Yeah, one more thing.
Land.
What? No, no, no. Just excuse me. ఒక్క నిమిషం ఎక్స్క్యూజ్ చేయను అన్న నన్ను. వాటర్ హైడ్రోస్పియర్ బెనిఫిట్ ఏంటి మనకి? యా, వన్ మోర్ థింగ్ ఐ వుడ్ లైక్ టు ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్. బెనిఫిట్ ఈజ్ వీఆర్ గెటింగ్ వాటర్. సో ఐ జస్ట్ సెడ్ దెర్ ఈస్ లెస్ అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ వాటర్ అవైలబుల్, ఫ్రెష్ వాటర్. సో వన్స్ ద ఫ్రెష్ వాటర్ ఈస్ అవైలబుల్ ఇన్ లెస్ క్వాంటిటీ, ఇఫ్ వీ యూజ్ దట్ వాటర్ ఇన్ ది సమ్మర్ సీజన్ అండ్ ఆల్ ద వాటర్ బాడీస్ లైక్ ఫ్రమ్ వేర్ వీ గెట్ ద వాటర్, మీరాలం ట్యాంక్ ఆర్ మంజీరా వాటర్ ట్యాంక్ ఆర్ గండిపేట నాగార్జున సాగర్ ట్యాంక్, దే గెట్ డ్రైడ్ అప్, ఎగ్జాస్టెడ్ వాటర్, రైట్? సో నెక్స్ట్ ఇయర్ అగైన్ వీ విల్ గెట్ ద వాటర్ ఆర్ వీ నీడ్ టు, ఐ మీన్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎగ్జాస్టెడ్ పర్మనెంట్లీ. వీ విల్ గెట్
వాటర్ గెట్ అగైన్,
వీ విల్ గెట్ అగైన్. వాట్ ఈస్ ద సోర్స్?
రెయిన్.
రెయిన్
వాటర్, అబ్సల్యూట్లీ ట్రూ. రెయిన్ వాటర్. వాట్ ఈస్ రెయిన్ వాటర్? రెయిన్ సైకిల్ కదా, రెయిన్ సైకిల్ అంటాము, వాటర్ సైకిల్ అంటాము. బెస్ట్ వర్డ్ ఈస్ హైడ్రోలాజికల్ సైకిల్. కెన్ ఎనీ వన్ డిఫైన్ వాట్ ఈస్ హైడ్రోలాజికల్ సైకిల్? సింపుల్లీ, సింపుల్ డెఫినేషన్. ఓకే, ఐ విల్ డూ దట్. ఇట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ ఎవాపో ట్రాన్స్పిరేషన్, కండెన్సేషన్ అండ్ ప్రెసిపిటేషన్ యాజ్ పర్ నౌ. ద డెఫినేషన్ ఈస్ డిఫరెంట్, ఐ విల్ డిఫైన్ ఇట్ లేటర్. నౌ వీ విల్ సే ఎవాపోట్రాన్స్పిరేషన్, కండెన్సేషన్ అండ్ ప్రెసిపిటేషన్. వాట్ ఈస్ ఎవాపోట్రాన్స్పిరేషన్ మీన్స్? రైట్. దెన్ ట్రాన్స్పిరేషన్ ఫ్రమ్ ద ప్లాంట్స్ అండ్ యానిమల్స్. దెన్ కండెన్సేషన్ ఆన్ ఎ సబ్స్ట్రాటమ్ ఫ్రమ్ వేపర్ టు లిక్విడ్ అండ్ దెన్ ఇట్ గెట్స్ కన్వర్టెడ్ ప్రెసిపిటేషన్, దట్ ఈస్ రెయిన్. సో వాట్ ఈస్ ద ఎవాపరేషన్ యాజ్ దట్ గర్ల్? వాట్స్ యువర్ నేమ్ మై డియర్? కీర్తి. వెరీ గుడ్, ఐ అప్రిషియేట్ యూ మై డియర్. ఎవాపరేషన్ ఫ్రమ్ ద సర్ఫేస్ ఆఫ్ ద ఓషన్, ఓషన్ అండ్ సీస్, బికాస్ దట్ ఈస్ ద మేజర్ అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ సర్ఫేస్ వాటర్ ఎక్స్పోజ్ టు ద ఎక్స్టర్నల్ ఎన్వైరన్మెంట్. సో ద మ్యాక్సిమమ్ అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ రెయిన్ కమ్స్ ఫ్రమ్ ఎవాపరేషన్ వాటర్ ఓన్లీ. ఎవాపో ట్రాన్స్పిరేషన్ లో ట్రాన్స్పిరేషన్ విల్ బి వెరీ లెస్ అమౌంట్, బట్ ఎవాపరేషన్ విల్ బి లార్జ్ అమౌంట్. And that evaporated water comes from the oceans and seas. Can we say now that more than 97% is not useful for us? No, it is very much useful. Why? Because the major part of the water in the rain comes from oceans and seas through the hydrological cycle. That is why it is very useful to us. I mean, the oceans and seas are very much useful to us because it every year they are the one which who brings us fresh water regularly, right? So that with this hydrosphere done, so what is that we are giving in return to hydrosphere? What we get from hydrosphere? Agriculture, plants, irrigation water, right? Then seafood, then water for domestic agriculture and industrial purpose, right? Then what is that we are giving in return to water? Water pollution, right? Just now you have answered, one fellow boy has answered it already. So we are giving in return water pollution to the nature. So that's it. And lithosphere, coming back to lithosphere, what is lithosphere?
Rocks.
Rocks, very good, beautiful. Rock is lithosphere. The land, rock, right? What is the difference between land and rock? Both are lithosphere, but lithosphere means absolutely rock. Then what is land? Land is nothing but the solid part of the earth which is made up of rocks. If you dig the solid for part, you can find some powder called soil, and you can even find rocky material like boulders, big or small boulders will be there, right? That is called a rock. So land is comprised of a rock. Rock is rock contains minerals and ores. Depending on that, rock can be of different kinds, like we can say igneous rock, metamorphic rock, sedimentary rock, granite, marbles, right, magnetite, quartzite. All these are nothing but different types of rocks, sandstone, all that. So with that, the land comprises of rocks, right? So what is soil again? We have one more thing. The land and rock, same thing. Then what is soil? Okay. Soil is nothing but the superficial layer of the earth crust is called as soil. which will be around few inches on the top soil antamu. And it doesn't only contain the earth part that is inorganic, but also consists of organic, then only it can be called as a soil. Otherwise, it is not soil. It's soil is a biota which consists of organic and inorganic components, right? So that is what soil is. That is land. Land will be, I mean, distributed around a thickness of 40 kilometers in the continental zone and 12 kilometers thickness in the oceanic floors. At the oceanic floor, the land thickness will be 12 kilometers and continental zone, it will be 40 kilometers. This is lithosphere, right? Now, what are the benefits of having lithosphere to us? Come on. Do we have any benefit of
yes, sir.
Right, absolutely. What is that one?
We do live on lithosphere.
Right, we do live. Now you are sitting, standing, walking on the land. So it acts as a base settlement for us, right? To grow the plants, to grow the agricultural crops, trees, for construction activities, right? Many things we do, infrastructure.
Minerals also, sir.
Right, next one. Next is minerals. We get minerals and other salts from the land. Even the precious materials, metals, stones, everything. That's it. Still anything else is there? Yeah, how we are able
natural
to...
Natural gases.
Right, natural gases. Energy sources, right? Coal, petroleum products and natural gases are the energy sources which are embedded within the earth, endowment of the earth, what we get as a benefit from the earth, lithosphere. Only these energy resources are there. Do we have any other energy resource also? Other than petroleum products, fossil fuels, coal, CNG kakunda, inkemanunda. Okay, what is there if you go deep into the earth? First core, mantle,
crust
or inka lopal kelte magma untundi. What is magma?
It is
lava, molten magma antaru. When it is present in the ground, we call it molten magma. That is, rocks have been molted or liquefied due to high heat, and when it comes onto the top, we call it lava. Can we explore that into form of energy? Yes or no? Yes, it is called as geothermal energy. Geo means land, thermal means heat. The heat which is present in the land can also be explored as a energy, geothermal energy, right? That is one more benefit. Still any other benefit of the land? Energy sources, minerals, and a base for settlement. Three answers you people have given. Very good, beautiful. Still any more answers?
Stores water. Ground.
Right, my dear. Absolutely true. Right, it stores water. Just now I said, why this Hyderabad city developed? Because beside the bank of Musi River. Why Musi River started flowing in this area only? Why not it flow in other direction? Because of the elevation of the ground topology, topography or geomorphology of the land. That is, the land slope is present in such a way that the water starts moving here. Why Sarnagar Lake is there? Because that land is the most depressed land in that area where water got stored. So that is how lakes, ponds, rivers, streams will form, which will enable the people to survive in that particular area. So it is the land which is storing water. If the land doesn't store that water, where that water will go? What is the end of a river? Where is the river merges itself? In a ocean or a sea. So that river will end up in an ocean or a sea. So we cannot hold the water, right? We cannot hold the water. It will go and merges itself into an ocean and it becomes salt, saline water, which we cannot use anymore. So it is the ground which is making the hold water, which is making available for our purpose, right? So that is how we can say The ground holds the water on the surface and even in the ground, groundwater. Right? Land holds the water. Beautiful answer. Who gave this answer?
Sai Kumar.
It's Sai Kumar. Okay, very good. Sai Kumar, Prithvi, and that girl. Right? Very beautiful. People are giving very good answers. Inka unnai konni benefits, but we will discuss one more. Why we are able to stand work? Why we are not, I mean, something like moon?
Gravity.
Gravity, right? Gravity is there. That's why atmosphere is holded to the earth because of the gravity. Otherwise, it would have been lost in the environment, in the universe. So that is also one of the benefits. So these are benefits, right? So minerals inga chala untai. So that is lithosphere. And with this, we have completed atmosphere, surface of the earth to space, lithosphere, surface of the earth to inside, then hydrosphere, all the water bodies, which gives us more lot of benefits. So left with the last sphere, fourth one of the environment, called as biosphere. Where we can see this biosphere? Can we see this biosphere? No, absolutely not. Why? Because it is not a separate sphere. It is a combination of all these three spheres where the life exists is called as a biosphere. That is the tropospheric layer of atmosphere where oxygen and CO2 are available and nitrogen are available for the survival of life. And then the topmost layer of the earth or land, that is soil, and all the water bodies where life is possible, all that comprises of biosphere. So with this, we have done the definition of environment. Environment ante not just surrounding, surrounding and raste kuda you will get 2 marks, not an issue. But still, what it contains in the surroundings means atmosphere, hydrosphere, lithosphere, and then biosphere, combination of three, that is environment. So next is scope and importance. What is scope? First of all, tell me, what is scope? Scope and ante a word meaning cheppandi. Scope word meaning cheppandi. Don't tell me scope of environmental science. What is scope? Okay, then I will ask you one question. You people are very good, right? I mean, you all got the choice to select the branch of MCET, I mean, of engineering through MCET. So why did you people selected ECE? Because you can say, sir, we have very good scope in this. Yes, sir, or no?
Sir.
Yes. Scope and entity. Job prospects, right? Yes or no? Again, right? We can get good jobs. Yes or no? No ante nen answer vere cheptanu. Okay. Yes, we can get good jobs. That's why the first creamy layer will get into the ECE. That's why I always prefer ECE branch to be taught. Right? Dealing with creamy layer and the best students will be very good. So, why the best students will come into ECE? Because it is the most demanded subject in the engineering, electronics and communication. Why? Because there is a very good scope. Job prospects will be there. I mean, you can get the jobs in the campus jobs, right? Placements. Why somebody will offer you a job with 15 lakhs or 20 lakhs of pay, annual pay? Why? Because
of skills.
Very good, my dear. Absolutely true. Because of the skills you have, right? They are paying 20 lakhs per annum, say, suppose. Will they get loss or a benefit? Definitely, they expect more benefit. They are paying only 20 lakhs to you, but they will get benefited more than 20 lakhs from you because they need to earn. And then a part of it will be shared with you only, right? So what you are giving them profit, they are just sharing. It is not a salary. It is just a honorarium. They are sharing that amount with you because you cannot hold a company. You have to work there, right? How they are getting more benefits from you? Because of your skills. What they are doing your skills? They are putting it in the society and getting benefited. They are selling. in the market, either they sell it in the market or they put it in the market, which, so what is you people are doing? You are developing some technology or something which is useful for the betterment of the society, right? So what is that? What technology you are doing, developing, is the useful for the society, for the betterment of the society. What is that? That is nothing but the definition of engineering, right? Engineering definition is the art and science which can be developed to improve the betterment of the life of the society and the people in the society is called engineering, right? So same thing you are doing, and that people are earning money and they are sharing the profit with you people, right? So how you are able to do that? Because you have the skills, you have the knowledge, right? First thing is you have the knowledge. That is primary. That is not enough to get the this scope or this profit in the society. The knowledge what you have, the skills what you have, and what technology you develop with that should be useful for the society. There should be a need of that technology, right? If you are still developing any technology, what has people done long, long ago with the same quality of work and efficiency, what is the use? There won't be any use. This is already there, nobody will take, right? If you are developing just a smartphone, right, nobody will take, because there are a lot of smartphones. You need to add one more feature, or you need to do it at the less cost, more advanced, right? So that is what the technology needs. So that is the scope of electronics and communication. Similarly, what is the scope of environmental science? Now you need to answer, my dear. I've explained it very well. I feel that. Maybe you feel or no, I don't know. ECA scope nenu cheppina naaku ardham ayindi. Meer ee environment science scope cheppandi. In your own language also you can speak, not a bound. Anyone? Somebody, Prithvi, Sai, Neha, Surya Teja, na inkevaro unnaru chaala mandi ammayilu abbayilu, they started speaking in the class. Okay, scope of environmental science is what we learn in this, right, should be applicable.
Pollution, sir.
Chepna na, chepu, very good.
Pollution, sir, pollution.
Right, absolutely, pollution, right. Not only pollution, you just, I will give you. Okay, we learn some subject here, environmental science, some techniques we are learning, then do we have a chance of applying that knowledge? Yes, absolutely. Why? Environment is getting disturbed. Environment is getting detrimental impacts on the environment, right? Environment getting spoiled. There is air pollution, water pollution, soil pollution, noise pollution, thermal pollution, light pollution, nuclear pollution. Lot of human pollution is also there in the environment. Recently, the COVID virus is also entered into the environment and affecting everybody, right? So environment is getting spoiled day by day. People are making it, spoiling, right? Maybe knowingly or unknowingly. So is there any chance of using our technology to improve the quality of environment? Yes, absolutely. Lot of scope is there. So that is the scope of environmental science. What we study, we need to apply that knowledge, skills to improve the quality of environment. Is there, if the environment is very clean, good, there is no need of applying the quality. We need to maintain it. But the environment is totally, bad, right? So we need to apply that knowledge to improve the quality of environment. And who has to study this subject? Who should improve the quality of environment? Only environmentalist? Only politicians should have the knowledge of politics? Only people should have, financial people should have the financial information of the country or world? Right? No, everybody should have all the information. If you earn money, how do you, plan for the savings? If you don't know the financial status of a country or what is finance, all that, everybody should have every knowledge, right? If you develop a technology which will be best for the humans but worst for the environment, what is the use of that? So Everybody should know about environment. Why? Because whatever acts they do, knowingly or unknowingly, they should not harm the environment. They should be eco-friendly. Whatever technologies we develop, that should be eco-friendly technologies, right? So that is why it is also called as multidisciplinary subject. The environmental science is called multidisciplinary subject because it is important for each and everyone, not only the technical, engineering, science, commerce, management, medicine, right? All the people, economics, right? Finance, everybody need to study this because their attitude should be towards environment saving, safeguarding the environment, but not misleading the environment, right? Or affecting, adversely affecting the environment. That is why it is needed. So this is scope of environmental science. Next is importance of environmental science, right? Is it important for us to learn environmental science? Now you need to answer.
Yes, sir.
Right. Yes. Thank you. Yes, sir. Nanduk nenu continue cheyalsi vastadi lekapothe badavadi meek classes cheppakuntam aapeyalsi vastunde. Yes, absolutely. It is needed, my dear. How we can answer this question? I would like to answer this question in a while, okay? First, let us see. It is, what is scope? Scope is essentially a multidisciplinary approach. That's it. It's a multidisciplinary. Everybody should read it, study it, understand it, know it, then use the knowledge to safeguard the environment. Then, importance of environmental science. I would like to answer this question in two statements. One is, impact of humans on environment, right? Because in the first class and today also we have examined or analyzed that we are taking benefit. The nature is providing us with lot of benefits like troposphere, air, hydrological cycle, all that, and the stratosphere, protection from UV radiation, mesosphere, protection from meteors, hydrosphere, water resource, lithosphere, many benefits we spoke just now, right? So these are all the benefits what we got. So we need to use these benefits sustainably, but we are using them and we are spoiling them again. So what is the impact of how we are dealing with the environment? That is what impact of humans on environment. If we say we do something to the environment, right? I'm doing something, maybe it is good or a bad. If it is bad, will it remain as it is? Environment will bear it like that? It will take everything on it, right? No, it will have a equal and opposite reaction, what is called as impact of environment on humans. I would like to explain these two statements, which can be explained as importance of environmental studies with photographic explanation, right? So impact of humans on environment, first thing in this, look at it. Are you able to see the screen, my dear? Is it visible?
Yes, sir. Yes,
right. So first four photographs, what is this? This is huge amount of waste, solid waste. It is plastic waste, or generally we can say the waste. Huge piles or mountains of waste is getting accumulated in the environment, and we don't have proper method to treat it, right? It is getting accumulated and it is spoiling the environment. Second picture, you can see this. This is, I mean, the air. This is nothing but a thermal power plant, power station, where huge amount of coal is being burnt and which releases gases, which, and a major gas what released from the coal power plant, coal burning, is what? What gas is the major gas? White colored, I mean, you can see the cloud, white cloud is a carbon monoxide, right? Carbon monoxide, oxides of sulfur, nitrogen, and gases which are polluting the environment. The solid waste, land is polluted, gases, air is polluted. Then here, the greenery is lost, right? All the greenery will be cut, burned, to acquire the land area either for industrialization, civilization, or agriculture. The forests are being cut down. Then the third last photograph, the ocean, the seashores are turning into dump yards, right? Why? Because we are dumping all the waste in the seas and oceans. That is why. So what will happen because of these activities, the global warming is occurring. And once we hear the term global warming, we can imagine the melting ice and the polar bears, right? They doesn't live in the water. They live on the icebergs and they won't survive enough, right? And the rivers in the world, right? This is the case in our country also. Even the auspicious rivers like Ganga, Yamuna, Saraswati, Brahmaputra, and even Musi River, the state will be the status or state of the rivers is the same situation, right? Lot of pollutants have been added, and then the solid liquid waste from the industries, toxic liquid waste, poisonous liquid waste is being dumped in the water bodies and even on the land, which is polluting the land and water. Then this is one more important, my dear. What is this? What you can get from this picture? This just now I have added this one. What is this? Two things we can get. Things. Very good. Chipnana.
Light pollution.
Right, my dear. First is light pollution, then urban concrete jungle. There are no greenery over there, which causes generation of heat island. Total heat will be trapped here, which causes the increasing that global warming is also occurring, and light pollution, which causes disturbance to the nocturnal animals. Animals which live in the nights, they are getting disturbed, and their migrations are also getting affected, which is called light pollution. And then these are eating a lot of plastic waste, what we are throwing in the water. They doesn't know that they are not edible, but they eat and they are getting killed because of this. And then this we can see, I mean, don't get disturbed by looking at this, but you can see them. And I think you people know better than me that once a dolphin mouth got struck in the bottle ring, and it could not open that, and it died due to starvation, living in its own place among that lot of food. And a seal got caught in a net, fish net, and such things have killed the living beings in the water, right? These are all the human activities. Am I sure? Can we blame the humans for these incidents in the nature? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, my yes, dear. Yes. Okay, don't feel bad, but still, yes, agree. That is a greatness. We need to agree our mistakes, right? These are only few, a fistful of things what I got, and I kept it in the net, on the screen. But there are a lot of other problems we are, creating in the environment, right? So what will be the impact of this on the humans by the environment? Look at this. This is the impact of environment on humans. What is that? The soil is getting polluted, water is getting polluted, air is getting polluted, then the rivers are getting dried, rivers, lakes, streams, ponds are getting dried, causing drought conditions some places. And some places there is excess of water causing flooding. This picture I have taken from the recent Hyderabad floods in October 12, 13th last year, right? So then even this is what happens, biomagnification, that is the pollutants what we throw in the water, air or soil, they enter into the food system, food chain, and from there it enters into the human body, and that causes abnormalities like what happened recently in Andhra district, right? Many people got affected with chills or that mental retardation, something like fits, right? Got affected. And that is because of this heavy metal got biomagnified, entered into the food system. And then this situation, current situation, COVID, right? The environment is getting spoiled and it will have an impact on us like COVID, right? We need to suffer. And then all these pollutants can affect the total human body, various organs, and can affect that. So this is what happens. Return, reaction from impact of environment on humans, right? So this is what the importance of environment. Next topic will be need for public awareness. I will explain it in the next class. Now I would like to take attendance, and tomorrow Wednesday we have one more class, my dear, 3 to 4. Try to attend that class. Last week Wednesday I was there in the class, opened, and I saw, I mean, I was sitting, but nobody has joined. Maybe your timetable is different, but make a note of this. You have next class on Wednesday. Wednesday 3 to 4. If you have any doubts, you can ask me now. Just allow me to take your attendance.